Today, let us see the various CMA formats for today. Let us see how the various formats of CMA forms look like. I would like to show you the CMA form number 1, CMA form number 2, and form number 3 today. This is a CMA form number 1, which gives the particulars of the existing and proposed credit limits from the banking system. If you look at, you have the working capital limits from various banks, the name of the bank, nature of facility, existing limits, extent to which the limits were utilized during the last 12 months, balance outstanding as on date, and the limit now requested. The same figure is for bank A and bank B. Similarly, for the term loan, name of the bank or financial institution from where the term loan is availed, the sanction limit, outstanding as on the date, if there are any overdues, the details, and the remarks. Let us now move on to the form number 2. The form number 2, as I have told you, consists of 5 columns. The first one giving the particulars, second and third the actuals, and the fourth one is the estimate, and the fifth one is the projections. So the column number 2 and 3 here in this example furnishes actuals as on 31/3/2013 and 2014, and it furnishes the particulars like gross sales, domestic sales, export sales, less the taxes, what is the net sale, what is the percentage of fall in sales compared to the previous year, any other operating income, then total income, and then it also gives the raw material consumption, the cost of production, cost of sales, the total cost of operation, operating profit before interest and after interest, and the addition of the non-operating income and deduction of the non-operating expenses, PBT and PAT. Now let us move on to the form number 3. Here again there are 5 columns. One is the particulars, the second and third is the actuals, year before last and the last year, current year estimates and projections, short-term borrowing from the bank, other current liabilities, total current liabilities, then it talks about the term loan, total term liabilities, total outside liabilities, then the net worth, the capital and the reserves, then total liabilities, move on to the current assets. You have the cash and bank balances, fixed deposits, receivables which are domestic, export receivables, inventory details, any other current assets and total current assets. Then the fixed assets, it gives the gross block, less depreciation, net block. Then it gives the non-current assets, intangible assets and the total assets. Then it gives certain information with respect to the tangible net worth, net working capital, current ratio, total outside liability to tangible net worth. This is how the form number 1, 2 and 3 look like. We will go to the form number 4, 5 and 6 in the next video before completing the form number 1, 2 and 3.